So continuing on my wiring diagram series, we have looked at the three-plate method, the two-plate method, often called taking the feed to the switch. And then I came across this method after a conversation with a gentleman that was doing his AM2 assessment. He'd gone in his pre-planning days, and I always recommend you do that, pre the assessment itself. And he was shown the following wiring diagram. This one just here, which was called wired through the switch. So this was shown to him. He brought the supply into the first two-way switch. We brought a three-core across to our intermediate, a three-core across to our last two-way switch, and then a cable up to the lighting point itself. Now, in this video here, I explain what was going on with the connections and my choice of conductors for neutral, etc. And it's worth checking out that video, but don't rely on that video to be the one that you'll have at your endpoint assessment. The AM2, AM2S and AM2E will evolve over time, and there's nothing stopping them asking you to wire in the lighting circuit in the traditional three-plate, two-plate, or in this scenario where it's wired through the switch. It's a bit like the conduit system, isn't it? Where we've got the feed into this common and the switching line out of this common here is what we see traditionally to a certain degree when we're wiring in PVC singles in the conduit system, but you actually would have taken the neutral directly up to the lighting point and just wired through like that. So that might help you put it into context of what sort of system this is similar to, taking the feed through the switch. So we're gonna look at now how we can take the feed to another area. So if you've wired your system like this in the real world and you think to yourself, well, now I need to take my supply into another room, we're gonna look at how we do that. Bearing in mind, we do have a neutral at every single light switch from the system that we've wired here, as well as a CPC. So we're gonna have a look at that, and we'll also look at how we can add more lighting points to the circuit. So let's break down what we've got here. So you probably would thinking, so if I've got a neutral at each of my lighting points, I could come off any of these points to feed another room. Well, let's think about that. So in this lighting point here, yes, we do have a CPC, and if I needed to bring a feed into another room, I'm gonna need to take the CPC through. I have a neutral, which is in a Wago style connector in there. And I have I got a permanent line connection? Well, this one here will be only energized when obviously the lighting point is on. And obviously we can't guarantee that these will remain on at all times as we flick between our switching sequences. So therefore, you wouldn't be able to come out of this two-way light switch with a neutral, a CPC, and a permanent line connection to another room, because one of these lines could come on and off in the switching sequence, meaning the room you've just wired may only work its lighting point in the energized position when the light in this room was on. So you wouldn't be able to take it out of here, and the same process repeats here. So you might have a neutral and a CPC, but you've got your strappers here, and you can't guarantee that they're going to remain permanently connected to the line conductor at all times in order to take a feed to another room. So we come back down to this one here, which was our first switch, which had our feed coming in, our permanent line into common, our neutral into our connector, and our CPC into the back of the box. This switch here, this two-way switch here, is the one that we can obviously use to go into another area. So we can take our supply from here and go to another room. We could do the three-plate method in there, we could do the two-plate, or you could do the wired through the switch method that we've got here. So all it would need us to do is take another connection out of, turn it around this way so you can see the writing's at the right way. Take another connection out of the common. So that would be where our permanent line connection is. So one out of here, so another one out of here, out of the common. You take another connection out of your 221, so it might be a case of having to swap it over for a three conductor connector of the Wago 221s. And obviously our CPC connection, and then go with a cable through the fabric of the building, under floors, through ceilings, etc., in order that you take a feed to the other room. So does that make sense? We can't come out of here and here, even though we have a neutral, which sounds great. We would come out from here to the next room. So we would take a cable from our common to the next room. We'd come out of our connector with our neutral, and we would come out with our CPC. I'll just put a little bit of yellow down it. And that would go off through the fabric of the building to feed the next area in which we're working in. So that's how we would do that. And I know it's quite easy to think, oh, maybe I could come off one of these two, but it's actually here where we've got a permanent line connection, CPC and neutral. We have CPCs and neutrals in these, but no consistent permanent line connection. So that would be taken off into our next area, and the process could repeat itself once again. Lighting points, we're probably used to where we're only bringing one cable up, which has a switching line, a neutral, and a CPC to a lighting point. I'm probably used to fitting LED downlights in that area. We'll reduce the number of cables here, so therefore it makes it easier for us to make connections. In this case, we would need to have a joint on the end. It might be a WAGO box, or it might be something like this one here, Collingwood easy fit connector, etc., in order that we can make our connections for our fixed wiring and our flexible wiring, and we can make some connections in here as well. Or we might be lucky enough to have a lighting point that actually has our connections. So we've got switching line, CPC neutral, neutral, CPC switching line, and our connections go in there. So in this case, we'd have these three in, and then we'd take another three off to feed another LED downlight. Okay, so that's the process there. So if we wanted more downlights in this system, exactly the same as we've looked at in our two plate system, we're going to just come out of here in the same area to a series of downlights, depending on how many you can have. Remember, there is a limit to the number of lighting points you can have on one switch. I recommend you check out our eFix Apprentice Hub and Know-How tabs. The Know-How tab's got a CPD on that. So we would come out with our switching line conductor. We would come out with our neutral. And we would come out with our CPC across to the next light in the area, in order that these two lighting points then come on together. So now we've added an additional LED downlight, or downlight of some variety, by just introducing another cable. So we just introduced the neutral, CPC and switching line from the first light in the area across to the second one, and we repeat the process on for as many downlights as you can have. But remember to check out that know-how tab on the efix.co.uk in order to look at part L of the building regs, which actually suggests the maximum number of points you can have on one switch. Okay, so we just bring it and we just keep repeating the process for the number of downlights that we need. So we bring it across, and then we've obviously got three downlights now connected to this switching sequence. So we've got two-way and intermediate. In this case, now we're controlling three lights. We've now worked out that we can take from our first two-way switch that has our permanent line, our neutral and the CPC, the supply over to the other area that you want to wire in using this method here. I recommend that for your AM2, AM2S and AM2E, that you've mastered all your skills, not just necessarily how to wire a maybe quite a simplistic lighting circuit, but make sure you're fully averse with all the wiring systems and all the ways of connecting stuff. I will try and continue on to do more videos helping you towards your endpoint assessment, AM2, AM2S and AM2E, as the months and weeks go on. But this one here was all about, as we go back to our original drawing, was all about wired through the switch. And I just extended it on to say to you, if you use this method in the real world, your feed can come out of here to go to another area. And as always, we continue to loop onto multiple points on the same switching system in the same area. So as always, I just hope this video has been some help.